Here on KCOH 92.9 FM HD2. Remember, y'all can check us out live and direct on KCOH Radio. Or y'all, matter of fact, if y'all friends with Skylar on Facebook, she's doing her Facebook Live, so y'all can chime in and comment on that. And y'all can tell Skylar how her lip gloss is like she just ate a whole bucket of chicken
she's
right now.
Popping, huh? Right? No, I'm addicted to lip gloss. I'm addicted to lip gloss, sorry. Okay, so hot topic time.
Ready? Top of time. What's going on?
Today's Veterans Day.
Yes.
Shout out to all the veterans.
Thank you.
We appreciate you for all of your service.
Yes.
Now, I put up a post on my Instagram, and a lot of people took it as a joke, but I was really being serious, so y'all have to go follow my Instagram and see my post, but it was really a serious post because since it was Veterans Day, I got some special veterans that I want to shout out. Not in the armed forces, but these are also veterans of a different type of war.
That
might be offensive.
Yeah. No, it wasn't offensive.
Yes.
It was not offensive.
When you're talking about Veterans Day and people who've given their lives to fight for our country, it is.
Yeah. People get offensive by everything.
We thank you for your service.
Oh,
we appreciate the brave fighting for us to have our freedom. Thank you. We appreciate that. Rob Kardashian.
Yes.
Yeah, what a segue.
No, but can we talk about these names for these children? Since Rob and Blac Chyna had their daughter, congratulations. The birth of a baby is always a wonderful thing.
Dream Kardashian.
Can you imagine?
Exactly.
But can you imagine going to school? You know how bad? I mean, my name is Skyla. That's the name that I was given by my mother. I was teased so bad all through school. I mean, like, teased. Like, bad.
But you're beautiful. Bad,
bad, bad.
Now?
Yes. But it took me forever. I mean, like, it was, and thank you, that was a nice compliment. But literally, like, I was called all kinds of names.
Oh, yeah.
You know? So I can't imagine.
Well, that's what children do, though.
But Kardashian.
But then again, you gotta also look at this side of it. This is Rob Kardashian's and Blac Chyna's child. They're going to be automatically popular. It's not like their parents are just regular people.
That's true. But my more...
Well, yeah, but how long can they make sex tapes and make money off
social
media?
And sell socks. Because
forever.
She did videos, but they can't do that forever.
That's
their money's going to run out.
But still, they will be... Blac Chyna and Rob Kardashian's child. So they will always be their claim to fame.
Of course.
Blue Ivy. Her parents
Kardashian.
Are Jay-Z and Beyonce. The West is North and... What's the other one? East West?
Saint
West, whatever. So these are children of superstars. So it's like it's not like they're gonna be like the sore thumb.
They all have to go to the same family reunion.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you got North, you got Dream, you got Saint.
But these children are not gonna be normal children.
No,
they weren't born in the world
time,
to be normal.
I do find it kind of funny though because Dream is the only child with a Kardashian last name.
Right.
Yes.
And everybody wants to be a quote-unquote Kardashian. So here you have Dream as a Dream Kardashian.
Yeah, Rob's kids are the only ones that will actually have the Kardashian name.
Exactly. And if he has a son, then that'll really be the only Kardashian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, shout out to the immigration laws that passed. Because if it wasn't for that, then Kanye wouldn't have Kim.
Immigration?
Huh?
Sir.
Oh, he has lost his ever-forsaken mind.
Sir.
So, we do have a new president since our last show.
Yeah.
Why are you looking at me? I don't like Trump or Hillary.
So,
for some reason, usually when you're watching on election day and the screen light up, you might have some blue states, some red states. My screen was totally
All red. Yeah.
Well, yeah, it was a lot of red states. Now, Hillary did get a few states, but this is what everybody was so upset about, because if it was up to the popular vote, Hillary Clinton would be our president-elect right now.
I didn't realize so many people didn't understand the Electoral College either, though.
Well, then again, a lot of people don't know politics like that. A lot of people think, when I go out to vote, this is who I'm voting for. If this person gets the most votes, this is who's going to win.
Right, and that's
not
the case.
That's why I say local and city elections, yes, your vote will count. But then you have the popular vote where Hillary was winning, in the popular vote, then you have the electoral kind of like,
what people don't realize is that the local and city and state elections is actually what controls the country.
Yes.
Right.
Because you have the Senate, you have the House of Representatives. So midterms this time is going to be one of the biggest elections. Because if you're upset with Congress and Senate, midterms is when you change the course of history.
Now, one thing that I do not like that I have been seeing a lot of reports about is that since Trump has become the president-elect, there has been a lot of reports of racist whites, bullying minorities like Muslims, mm-hmm. Mexicans, black people. Like, I seen a post where this girl was at a gas station. She said, like, four white guys hopped out on her, and they was basically bullying her, threatening her, and she couldn't do nothing but sit there and cry.
But it's gone. Okay, you know, I'm going to say it's going both ways. I mean, yes. I saw the video where, you know, the young black guys had, you know, were beating up the white guy out of his car. The thing is, it's become so racially divided with this situation.
Trump, I consider our country is totally divided all over.
Yes, it's we've gone back 50 years in a lot of
back more than 50 years.
Yeah, well, at least 50 years. So the thing is we have to remember to unite. We are smarter than this. He may act like we are not, but we are.
But
so we need to.
This is what
so
I think.
We need to pull together and do what we know
but
is
have
right.
Have you noticed how the hip hop community has stepped up and stepped in so many ways?
Yeah, shout out to people like T.I.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was bringing up when they were protesting in Chicago the election because Chicago voted for Clinton, and he was out there with the people, calming folks down. Telling people, you know, getting people excited, and he's not the only one.
There's a lot of people who's been, you know, who's really stepped up.
But it's also been a platform for people who are totally nuts in the head to do stuff, like the lady who defecated on the sidewalk.
That
and
was
who,
gross.
It's disgusting. Not normal.
People are using this platform,
and this is not the platform
I don't know if y'all saw on Trump's website, but he took down one post he had. It was a racist post. But he put up a picture of him holding the LSLG. What? How do you say it? For the lesbian, gay?
Yeah, LSLG. We
know
BT.
Yeah, y'all know
what
I mean.
I know
BT. Shout out to them. But he was holding their flag. And I said, wait. Did Trump just finesse these rednecks to get their vote, to get in office and just switch everything up?
You know what? I've been wondering because if you saw today, he has an interview tonight on a news program where they started talking about the repeal of Obamacare, Affordable Health Care Act. And he completely turned, he did a 180
right,
on it.
Right, so
it
was like,
and
Trump,
was like, oh, I might not do that.
Well, that's the thing. I think he's smarter than a lot of people think he is. And, you know, in the past, there was things in the past that he had different views on. And he kind of changed up. So it may really shock a lot of people that voted for him because he might go back the other direction and really shock people.
Well, he is a liar, so, you know.
Yeah.
No, he's a businessman. But speaking of politics.
Okay, but wait, real quick. I want to say this, okay, real quick. The thing is, I saw this, you know, I spoke out on this on Instagram today. Someone had put up a video of his 10-year-old son and was making comments about his son. Leave his child alone.
Yeah, leave his child alone. Leave
him alone.
You don't talk about people's children. You can talk about Trump all day long. Call him orange, call him Cheeto.
Liar. You can do whatever you want. I don't care. I don't care where you protest. I don't care. As long as you're not touching anybody else, but leave his child alone.
At least wait till you get 18.
Yeah, it's just not okay.
And I'm starting to get a little tired of the shaming of Melania. Just...
I understand, that's not what I'm talking about.
So when they started saying, you know, going in on she's going to be our new first lady, and there was, remember when Michelle Obama became the first lady and they were upset about her arms being bare? So people started comparing Michelle Obama's arms to Melania Trump's nude and girl on girl pictures. And at first, it was just like, okay, you know, the hypocrisy. But then it just took a whole nother
turn. And
I said this on our other radio show.
This is the thing. I've taken, not nude, I haven't done anything like that, but I've done pictures and I've done, you know, he's so silly. He's just a liar. You're friends with Trump. But the thing is, when you make a decision to do something for yourself, business-wise, it was her business. She wasn't even married to him. It had nothing to do with him. It had to do with her career. It was choices that she made as a woman with her body. And I think that is off limits too.
But however, if that was Michelle who had did that, she would have been drugged all through
the
dirt.
Okay, but this is the thing. It would have been drugged through the dirt prior to Obama being elected. And if all these people who supposedly know so much and they're so up on their politics, they should have found these pictures and put stuff out.
They did.
They've been out. The pictures
been
out.
Well, now they're really putting them out. I didn't see them before now.
Oh, honey, y'all. Those pictures been out. They've been there. That's
enough about Trump. They've been holding on to that. Yeah. So
more importantly,
just leave them alone.
Shout out to Michigan because they have a brand new councilman. Actually, he's the youngest councilman.
Oh, yes.
Jewel Jones. He's the youngest councilman elected in Inkster's history in the state of Michigan. He's actually 21, I believe. 2021. He's 20 right now, but he's going to be 21 by the time he goes to school. He's a full-time student at University of Michigan in Dearborn. He's a member of the Army Reserve. He's always into politics and whatnot. So he's the youngest councilman in Michigan ever. So shout out to him. And that's something positive. So yeah, that's hope.
No, but something else came out of that too. In Minnesota, where Aman Omar becomes the first Somali American congresswoman. She was a refugee, came over from a war-torn country, Somalia, came to the United States, paved the way, and now she's elected to their house.
That's pretty cool.
And she's the first one ever to do that. And that is a huge, huge situation for that community.
You're right. Now, another thing that I saw over social media was a lot of posts about like when Hillary Clinton did not get elected, I seen a lot of mothers was posting about how their daughters was just so upset because they had so much faith in Hillary Clinton that if she was to become president, that they thinking that I too one day could become president. And then when Hillary lost, they're like, you know, it's like their dreams were crushed. So y'all can still encourage your daughters that, yeah, yes, one day you could be president. I mean, it just wasn't time for Hillary at this moment, but who knows, next 4 years from now, if Michelle Obama decides to run, she might become president, or you know, whoever, if they're another qualified woman, you know, they got enough money to make it to that point, then yeah.
Well, that was a problem. I think there was enough people that didn't like Hillary, period. Well, it had nothing to do with her being a woman. It had to do with them not liking her.
You know what? It does have something to do with being a woman, because a lot of people, I mean, men and women.
No, I know women who said they wouldn't vote for a woman
because she's a woman.
She's a woman and has right. emotions, which I think is absolutely
ridiculous. But there's a lot of people who don't want to see a woman running this country. Yeah. Now, I don't mind. And it's like, I was... anti-Hillary. Actually, I'm anti-Hillary and anti-Trump. But I made a post about Hillary on my Instagram page, and another female, she just, like, ripped me to shreds. Like, why are you going against Hillary? You don't want to see a woman be president? Like, no, I just don't like Hillary. I don't mind right. if a woman is president. I don't like Hillary.
Yeah, well, I didn't really care for either one. I mean, I made that vocal from the beginning. So,
right.
But that was another thing that some people brought up, and someone put on my Facebook Live just now, that there weren't riots and stuff when Obama became president. That's BS. There was. You can find them if you actually see them. They're out there.
The same way.
There's stuff where they were putting up signs with right. Obama with a noose, and they were, you know, so it's all out there. It always happens.
The minorities are speaking out against Trump. They were speaking out against
Obama. Obama. Yeah, it happened. Way. It just happens. That's how our country
is. Talking about leaving
the
country and all that type of stuff.
Yes, that's how our country is. It's always like that.
Those were the hot topics, and if y'all have any more hot topics, y'all feel free to give us a call right here on KCOH, the Friday Night Kickback. Y'all give us a call, 713-526-1230, and it's actually 8:30. We're going to get into some music.
Let's do it.
All right. Skylar, you want to hear this song, right?
I do. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. This is the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH in Houston, 92.9 HD2 on your FM dial, KCOH on your TuneIn app, or KCOHradio.com. What's going on?
Hey, what's up? Hello.
Hey. Now we'll have some fun.
We need to find myself.
For the person that was asking me to interact, I can't interact when I'm live on air. We're live. This is a live radio show on 92.9 FM in Houston. So when I'm live on the air, I can't talk to you. I can smile. I can blow kisses. But
you can show
I can't
your
talk. No, I can't. Shut up, Zeke. So that's why we don't.
He says, play his request.
It depends. What's your request? Let's see if we can get DJ Zeke Bobby to play it. You won't play my request.
I'll just play this.
Yeah.
Look, I'll play whatever y'all want to hear, but Skylar has to flash the camera.
That's not happening.
No, I guess I ain't playing the music.
Yeah, that's not happening.
I'm about to ask.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. This is the Friday Night Kickback. Hey, that song that I asked you about, do you have that song?
What song?
Joey Purpin featuring.
I don't even know what it is.
Oh, I liked it a lot. I heard it. Hey, what's up, Ty? What's up, Matthew? Thanks for tuning in. Juan Carlos, Aaron, Roderick, Kevin, thanks for tuning in. Tony, Jamie, Lisa, Raymond, Michelle, Jaden, Donovan, Shannon, Michael, Roderick, Titi, Elliot, what's up, Loso? How are you guys tonight? Hey, James, thanks for tuning in. This is the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH in Houston. And we are on a music break. We're having DJ Zeke Bobby doing some music for us. and we just went over hot topics, and we have some special guests coming in tonight. Sugar Maroon 5. Oh no, this is hip hop, baby. We don't do Maroon 5 on here. Zeke will dance. Zeke will sing it for you. Well, you can play it if you want.
I actually like that song too. That is literally my jam.
Did you see the video?
Yes.
The video is so dope. They just wow. Wearing these wigs.
I'm sure Zeke can mix it over. I'm sure he can mix it.
Hey, Miss PR, Jennifer. Hey, Ray. Thanks for tuning in.
Okay, so my friend does have it, but he's at the airport.
Yes, Juan Carlos. I agree with that. Let's stick together. All people. Hey, Jennifer, are you coming out to the Black College Expo tomorrow? My neck a bunch of frozen jewels. I can show you what them bitches do. They did. It's okay though. I know how you feel. What's up, Bobby? Thanks for tuning in. I hit a lick, ain't have to split it, baby. I'm trying to get the clean version of this song. Oh. This is the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH 92.9 HD2 on your FM dial if you're in Houston, KCOH on your TuneIn app, or, I have a dorky laugh, or KCOHradio.com. Hey, what's up, Damien? Tomorrow it's from 10 to 5, but I will be there about noon. I will be there about noon tomorrow. There's going to be a lot of people out there, though. So it'll be a good networking opportunity for you, too. Plus, support the kids.
You're not going to what?
On the first? What's up, guys? You're tuned into the Friday Night Kickback. Is this the event that you're talking about? Okay. I'm going to leave you guys with Courtney. Let her dance with you guys. Here, Courtney. Will you entertain the masses, please?
Oh, bro.
Bro, come
here.
Oh, as long as y'all are here.
Okay. Hey, masses! Hey.
I thought it was in there. Huh?
Hi, guys. Okay, sorry. So, don't leave. Oh, Ty, her shirt says something about your man crush Monday. I don't know. Are you her man crush Monday? No? I don't think so. Okay. Anyway, any of y'all have the clean version of the song Black Beatles? Kind of need it tonight. I'm looking for it. I keep downloading the wrong version. Anyway, don't leave. Skyla's coming right back. Oh,
thanks,
Skyla.
Appreciate you today.
Whatever. I don't want it. That it don't sit like a horse. So anyway, don't leave. Skyla's coming right back. She just had to take care of some radio station business. So what else would you guys like for us to talk about today? We've covered Veterans Day. We've covered the elections. These muffins.
They turn me on some.
Anyway.
Hey, I need information about the Thanksgiving stuff.
What else?
Aww.
What y'all want to talk about?
They just brought me presents.
We on a sneak tip. Someone tells me those cupcakes are really for Zeke Bobby, but it's cool though. It's cool though.
Oh,
it's cool.
We're going to
y'all see, she opening her car. Calvin says, hey, Miss Flawless.
Hey, what's up, Calvin?
See, I done lost all your followers. My bad.
Hey, guys, you're tuned out of the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH. Hey. Weren't you just pink?
Yeah, he was. Oh, you're welcome.
They brought me a card and cupcakes.
This is my song too.
Baby. Oh,
they
brought me a Red Bull, too. They love me.
That was rough. Oh, she got the minis.
They look so good. How do I know what kind they are, though?
The red velvet.
Yeah, I taste like balls, so yeah, fine.
She's so nasty.
What's up, guys? You're tuned into the Friday Night Kickback.
Hey, it's the Friday Night Kickback. Come kick back before you head out to, what is it, Epic 22 tonight for the U of A homecoming takeover?
I don't know, but I know that's right about it.
Y'all, see, I'm going to tell y'all now. I don't like sweets, but I love red velvet cupcakes.
I love sweets.
It's too much
for me.
Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Girl, be mad if she bought a caretaker in my hair.
So this is even better.
You used to call me all night.
You used to. I haven't heard this in a while.
You used to
call me
all
night. I like it.
Here, so I'll put
them in the fridge. You used to call me all night.
What's up, guys? You're tuned into the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
With DJ Zeke Bobby in the mix.
Call me on my cell phone. Not always need you. Not always need you. I know when the hotline blinks.
That can only mean one thing.
What's that? I'm calling you on your cell phone. You better answer because I'm not going to call you.
You guys are tuned in the Friday Night Kickback.
Get out of the box.
Ever since I left the city, you started when lessons go
now.
Blessings and champagne out on the
What's going on, guys? Do you guys have a relationship topic you want us to talk about tonight? Otherwise, we're going to talk about what we want to talk about. So if you have something, let us know. Hey, KP. Thanks for tuning in. I love you, baby girl. We are Snapchatting, Facebook Living. We're on live on the air on 92.9 HD2 on your FM dial in Houston or KCOHradio.com. KCOH on your TuneIn app. And they bought me Courtney, I love you too. Courtney, you're gonna be at the expo tomorrow, right? Oh, Caitlin, come see me. I miss you. Bunches and locks. Courtney. He's playing some different music tonight. Hey, Kester, thanks for tuning in to the Friday Night Kickback. Yay, Courtney. Hi, Court!
Can you guys want to...
You want to come
on,
do it?
Someone want to email me the clean version of Black Beetle?
How
I'm about to do that. Juan, I think she liked tacos too, but she walked away, so y'all stuck with me. Me too, Courtney. Courtney, tell one of your friends to email us the clean version of Black Beauty Dolls. Like, no, for real though. This is a 911. I need my song.
Come my way.
Yeah, send it to Zeke, please. Skyla will be right back. Y'all are tuned in to the Friday Night Kickback on KCOHradio.com, aka 92.9 FM HD2 if you are in the city of Houston. And if you happen to be on the road, rolling around, driving, you can hit the tune-in app at KCOH. But at the same time, you can watch it. We are having way too much fun. SkylaDawn.com is walking around the building, passing out cupcakes. We got Ro Cook on the other side dancing. And you are listening to the smooth sounds of Zeke Bobby. Hey, Joe Whitfield, welcome to the fun. We about to party. I have taken over Skyla's live stream right now for the moment. It is hot in the studio. I just want y'all to know. So what are y'all doing this weekend? Like, it's Friday night. Where y'all going? What y'all kicking back to? Get one what? One of them cupcakes? Some cupcakes must be gone, though. You got some greedy people in here. To the other side of me. Because I'm going to tell you now. Lord Manning's calling. Hold on.
Are you ready?
Are we going back on?
KCOH
okay,
TV.
Hey, guys. Thanks for tuning in. He's doing ads right now.
Ads.
Okay, what time is it? 8:45. Okay. Relationship topic. Anybody have anything they want
to
talk about?
I thought you had someone you just lied to.
No, I have something, but I just want to see if there's anybody who wants to talk about it.
You know, I had one. I forgot what I was going to talk about. Though. It was something that happened recently to somebody. No, I forgot what it was, though.
Okay.
What relationship topic was that?
Let's see.
Chelsea, what are you going through this week?
I care about you. Stop.
I'm talking about somebody. Keep
thanks, Kevin. Hey, Antoine. Thanks for tuning in. Hey, guys. This is the Friday Night Kickback. We're about to go live. Yes. So this is the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH, 92.9 yes. HD2 yes. FM in the Houston area. Or KCOH on your TuneIn app if you have us on your phone.
I'll save the rest of you and me. Because he ate my last cup of
tea. He's so excited right now.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, guys. He's
my
just being.
I mean, forget. Yeah, I thought you
he's
up.
Just being.
Me and Zeke.
Yeah, he's just being Zeke. He's just being Zeke. Really hard? Yeah.
Motherfuckers are hard. I feel like my dude broke.
Okay, relationship topic.
When is the time? When do you ask for a threesome in a relationship?
Yep.
See, that's why we're not going to talk to you.
A threesome? No. That's not happening with me either, so.
I guess I just have a conversation by myself.
Need, yeah. You guys might need to think of something else. Hey, guys. Thank you, Dee. Thank you for your service to our country. We appreciate it.
Hey, so let me appreciate it, bro.
When is far too far?
Hey, what you mean?
20 seconds.
Oh, that's what it was.
Like the
this girl kept pressing me to eat her ass. I'm like, I don't do that.
Stop.
And don't do it.
Hey, Christian.
I'm not. But she's like, you know, you grew up, maybe
I'm
you
so
want
glad
to.
I'm so glad you're here. No, what were you going to, how far is too far? You mean like to drive or to travel or what?
No, like in a relationship, like things to do.
I think I'm talking about eating ass.
You ready? And you tuned into the Friday Night Kickback. Oh my gosh, Zeke is busy. Wrong show, wrong night.
Y'all, this is a mess.
Hey, let's talk about it on the Breakfast Club.
No, this is not the Breakfast Club.
Actually, we're better.
This yes, is we are.
This is 92.9 FM. This is a Friday night kickback. I'm sorry, guys. I'm Zeke Bobby Long with ScholarDog.com, Courtney, Nicole, and Roe Cook. Okay, who's trying to pick our relationship topic?
Listen, how far do you go in a relationship?
That's not what we was going to talk about. That's not what we agreed on.
Right. No, we did not agree on anything. Zeke agreed in his own head with his own committee that stays in there.
What to do. You just don't ask your partner.
This goes with that then.
You probably should have asked the one you were with before you got married. Before you're in a serious relationship. If you're playing around and joking, then
start from the top, bro. Give him the question.
What's the background? Because I was out there.
Yeah. Yeah, Courtney was out there talking to him.
How far is too far?
Yes, how far is too far?
Like sex-wise or?
Sex-wise, question-wise. Just say if me and you're dating, and some things I should not ask you, and some things I should feel comfortable asking you.
At what point in the relationship, though? Because when you're married, nothing's off limits when you're married.
But I think
no, when you're married, there has to be a respect, though.
Right. You're not going to bring anyone else into your bedroom.
Oh, of course that. I thought you meant like asking them something.
No threesomes.
Well, yeah.
Hey, but just say.
No tossing salads either, then.
Yeah, okay. So if that other question were to that.
Sorry, Mom.
Hey, tell your mama go tune out now.
I think that
wrong.
Is too far to push it. Look, yeah, that one is too far.
Look, I think a lot of things are too far. And a lot of things I won't do personally.
Well, I think just as any other topic that we've brought up in here is communication. You have to communicate from the beginning.
That's the most important key because, in every relationship.
Yes, but if you start out in a relationship, and I'm going to say intimately, if you start out and you say, you start out very conservative, and then you think that at some point it's going to go the other direction, think again. Or if you start out really wild, intimately, and then, you know, you think that once you get married or once you've been together long enough that it's going to, you know, not happen, then you're also living in la-la land.
But, you know, a lot of men complain about their wives. They say once they get married, then the sex pretty much stops.
But does it have to be, I'm sorry. You're married. Go ahead.
No, I was saying, and me and my husband talked about that the other night.
Well, you still popping out kids, so I don't think
it's No. We were talking about that the other night because he got into, like, during the day, we were texting each other, and, you know, we were just phone texting. So when he got into bed, he was like, baby, I was tired. And I was like, and we see how it is now when people be like, they don't have sex when they're married. It's like, it ain't that we don't want to. We tired.
For example, like when I was married, if you married and you got a full time grind and you got a side gig and kids and all that type of stuff, yes, you're gonna be tired. But then again, that's why, like y'all do, you set a time for yourself, kick the kids out, put them with your parents, and then y'all have what y'all do, and that's how Roe keeps getting pregnant.
But I also think that just from me knowing, I mean, I have a lot of guy friends and communicate a lot.
Yes, I
do, and I think that. I think that we need to, that women need to be a little bit more open and a little bit more,
stop being so bougie.
Yeah.
That too.
Yeah. Well, and realize that, see, this is a thing. I actually had this conversation with someone the other night, and women fundamentally, if you guys disagree with me, go ahead and, you know, say it. But when women fundamentally want security, whether it's financial or emotional, we want security. We want to know that we're safe, we're taken care of. So that could be whether it's a house over, you know, a roof over our head, or if it's, you know, emotionally, like, you've got my back.
Right.
Whereas, because we have friends and we have other ways, we have other outlets, but for a man, or, you know, we need security. Men need sex.
Right.
So it's
food.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and food.
And
but they can get food themselves.
Or that's what a side chick cooks too.
No, but we don't want a side chick. That's the point. The point is.
Hey, do your job.
Yeah, me and my husband got married. Lunchtime, like, hey, we got an hour. Let's go to the room, and I'm back to work. And it was just like that. Like today, if we busy, like, hey, I have to put Royce to sleep. I'll meet you in the room at 12:00. And we in and out, like.
But I think that's the problem that a lot of women don't realize is that it is super important to men, right, Zeke?
Of course.
Yes, it's super important to men. So for a woman to think because it's not important to her that, you know, because if her drive slows down or if her other needs are met and so that need is not as important, it is still just as important. The man can have everything else. He can have billions of dollars. He can have 17 houses. He can have Lamborghinis. Like, he still needs sex.
Yeah.
Women, that's not always the first thing on our mind.
Very true.
It is on theirs. So for women to not think that that's so important or to make that less important, that's where you end up with relationship problems. And I think women really need to get that, and men need to understand. You know, I've seen a lot of memes and stuff saying, you know, if she's asking money or she needs this or she, you know, your wife this. No, that is very important to women. Not money itself, but security. Security. So our number one thing is security. Their number one thing is sex. So you have to realize that.
And I make sure my husband has that. Like, no is, like, not an option. Not in his eyes, but, like, through my eyes, because I'm like, I've never had to tell my husband, no, I'm tired, I don't feel like it tonight, or I got a headache. Like, if he say something about it or start getting frisky, then it is what it is. I mean, it's...
You about to go like, right now, huh?
Stop. Stop. No.
But, I mean, it's just I know what it is. I'm not going to be that selfish person. And he's not that selfish person either to be like, you know, you'd have the kids all day or, you know, if he see I'm tired, then my husband will leave me alone and let me go to sleep. He's not selfish like that. And I'm not selfish to hold back and be like, nah, we good, bro.
So what's the farthest y'all ever went?
What you mean?
Like, that was the question, right? How far is too far? What's the farthest y'all went?
I mean, me and my husband, we done did everything. Oh. I mean, I done tried, you know, nine-laters and... You know, I ain't tried the other ones, but somebody told me about the fruit roll-up. I ain't tried that yet. But,
yeah, try that.
Well, I had someone that commented on my Facebook Live, and they said that they disagree. It's a man. Mm-hmm. He disagrees because he thinks that sex is as important to women as it is to men.
Yeah, some women just like it. I was a nympho, like, I had to...
If they have issues.
Yeah, from my husband. I mean, he was my boyfriend then, but that was my only source. So that's where I'm going to get it from.
But was it because of the sex or because of the security you felt from it?
No, it was just because of the sex. Like, okay. I wanted sex. I wasn't going to go sleep with nobody else. Like,
how do we know that?
Like, hey, what you doing? Shut up. Like, hey, what you doing? Yeah, you know, you know, or he'd be like, I'm coming to lunch today. I'll meet you to come to lunch.
So in your list of needs, both of you, like in your list of needs, would that be number one?
Yeah, that would be number one.
Okay, so it's more important than security. It's more important than having... Like, feeling like you have your emotional well-being taken care of.
Because if you know the man that you're with, and you know that, if you know, his main priority to make sure you got a roof over your kid's head.
No, but I'm saying if you already know that, mm-hmm. then you have that security already.
Yeah,
so security is more important.
Okay, well, security.
Yeah, see, that was what I was getting at. Because when I talk, you know, I have clients and I have a lot of girlfriends and we talk about this stuff, and I have guy friends and we talk about it. And that's the number one thing that I find with women is they want the security. That's more important. As long as they have security, they can relax and take care of everything else.
You can't have sex if you ain't got a roof over your head.
Right.
Actually, you can. Right.
You can.
This is a true story. Like 16 to 45. That was getting in.
Oh,
well, you know what I mean.
Thanks for sharing.
You know what I mean.
Thanks for sharing.
That's what I don't feel.
I ain't no willing to call the cops.
Courtney's like, I think my mom might be listening. I'm not talking on this subject.
Courtney, what college you went to again?
Hampton University.
Yeah, I know y'all get pretty wild
on
out
the
there.
Long
hey! Oh, no, the she's an angel.
The waterfront was the spot.
Wow. Oh, yeah? What you did at the waterfront? How far did you go? Hey, you know what? Sometimes outside is one of the best adventures.
No, not when you're on the water and there are water rats.
What's
water
wrong?
Rats.
Nutri rats, water rats, they will come up at night because they're nocturnal animals. I walked the waterfront.
The
goal is to get yours before the rats come out.
You're so funny. So you guys are tuned into the Friday night kickback on KCOH 92.9 HD2 on your FM dial or kcohradio.com if you want to listen to us and watch us on all of our mini cameras in here. You can tune on there or your KCOH on the TuneIn app. And this is the Friday night kickback. Let's get into a mix with DJ Zeke Bobby.
Yeah, it's just Zeke Bobby. I ain't got nothing
to do. Zeke Bobby. Now, did y'all see the two kids that died in the car from the carbon monoxide?
Hey, guys, you are tuned into the Friday night kickback.
I heard about that. I know it was two kids.
No, I did not hear about that.
They were like, 18 and 21 or 19 and 21.
Thanks for tuning in. This is the Friday Night Kickback on KCOH.
They say all the DJ record pools have Black Beatles.
Well, I couldn't find it all. I'm not in the record pool.
I almost turned off my phone.